Okay, a pleasant day to everyone. I am your subject teacher for the subject methods of research. I am Dr. Riza Missy Narciso, and I am handling research subjects such as CBM 300 for business administration and ACC 322 for accounting, management accounting, or accounting technology students. So this is my official email, riza_narciso@umindanao.edu.ph. So you may email me there if ever nga dili ko ninyo ma-reach out, or if na ako special instruction sa inyo ha nga kailangan nato i-email. And this is also my contact number just in case nga need na jud kay nga makontak ko ninyo. Okay, pwede ta mag-text in advance before ta mag-call sa ako ano. So let us start discussing about this what we call research and development programs for 2022 to 2027. So, all research topics of the students or the researchers in the University of Mindanao is kailangan naka-angkor sa tulo ka buok nga research agenda. And these are agriculture-related studies, environment, and disaster management. So, all of these three agenda, guys, is naa po na siya yung mga subtopic. Now, the question is, nga namang kailangan nato siya i-fit in sa kaning tulo ka research agenda. So it's because the University of Mindanao is aligning its research no into the research agenda of our president right now, President Ferdinand Marcos, in which he actually focuses on these three na major areas in his platforms or sa iyahang paglingkod. So that is why kita kailangan po siya nga mujay into this nga unsa research agenda, so that there is an alignment with the national na sa national nga setting and then sa ato apod nga level diria. Okay, so actually for the business administration and then the accounting, lahi-lahi na siya og mga program based na related topics that you can actually research upon. But how are you going to relate your research? No, how are you going to relate your research into the three research agenda? So if it's not in the variable, pwede nato na siya iguon sa respondents nga ato ang kandakan. So just like for example, in the agriculture related studies, you can actually conduct studies sa mga buy and sell related sa agricultural products like coconut, rubber, rice, corn, banana, and others. Pwede po ta mag-conduct og studies sa mga agricultural cooperatives. So natay mga agricultural cooperatives here in Davao del Norte or even in Tagum alone, no? So we just have to kanang identify kung kinsa tong mga cooperatives or mga companies. So naaputay appropriate nga office nga pwede nato duulan ana dito sa city for us to identify, or in the province for us to identify the name of the companies or cooperatives that you wanted to study. Then pwede po ta magkandak og study sa mga farmers, sa mga livestock nga engaged ng mga individual like ng mga hog raisers, mga nag-engage into poultry businesses, for example. Pwede ko ta magkandak og study sa mga banana plantation, mga employees sa banana plantation. Pwede po siya sa public market vendors, no? Kanang mga namaligya dirag fruits or vegetables. And pwede po ta sa Department of Agriculture or sa Municipal Agriculture's Office or sa City Agriculture's Office. Okay, so yan, those are just examples ha, and pwede pa ta pwede pagod mo nga mo explore basta mo relate siya sa agriculture, then pasok ang inyohang research. Okay, next is that kailangan next is on the environment, no? So pwede nato iguon ang office sa DENR, no? Like you're going to conduct study sa mga employees there. Pwede po sa mga street sweepers, for example, because they are related to environment. Mga garbage collectors na to, pwede po na siya. MDRRMO sa risk reduction na to, no? Although we have this disaster management, but it is still related to environment. Okay, like now na sigig baha lain ang panahon, for example. So pwede na siya nato nga ma-appeal gihapon siya as respondents ang MDRRM or CDRRMO under sa research agenda na environment. And then pwede po ta magkadak og study sa mga city or sa mga barangay responders nato. And even aga ni mga youth responders no nga established pod sa uban ng mga barangay or city. Then sa disaster management naman, these are the example of respondents that you can study. Pwede ta mga health workers or frontliners, no? Kasi they are part of kadang sa issue on health and safety, kasi part sa disaster management, no? Issue on health and safety. Then pwede po mga police personnel, yun, mga traffic enforcers or officers. Pwede po to balik ta sa MDRRMO or CDRRMO. So these are just examples na pwede na to explore as your respondents, no? So I know daghan pa kaayo kog wala mga na-mention diri, pwede jud gihapon mo explore ato for as long as you can answer the question asa sa tulo ka research agenda maigo ang inyong study. Okay, so again ha, first na to nga dapat i-consider, dapat mo align siya sa tulo ka research agenda sa research publication and productivity center sa University of Mindanao. Okay. So, now I know that you always have that question. Unsa man jud asa ko magsugod, ma'am? No? Unsa akong una nga buhaton, ma'am? Okay, so this is what you're going to do first, no? In conducting a research. First is mag-identify ta og certain problem in the organization or company where you wanted to conduct a study. Okay. So, in this part, ang purpose jud nato og mag-conduct og research is that kailangan makasulbad ta og problema sa isa ka community, sa isa ka organization, sa isa ka company. Dili lang kay nag-conduct og research is because for compliance only, para makapasar lang ta sa ato ang subject. Okay, always bear in your mind nga naganda ka ta og research because we wanted to address something. Muna siya ang first ninyo nga huna-hunaon. So, unsaon man naman para maka-identify ta ana? So, you can perform a key informants inquiry or otherwise known as KII to the prospect respondents to identify the research gap. Okay, research gap is very important. Okay, kanang na-identify nato nga problema nga ginaingon sa mga prospect respondents nato, muna siya ang dapat nato nga i-address. Okay? Now, part sa introduction ninyo nga part sa kanang IMRAD paper, kailangan nato makit-an dira ang research gap. Nya karon, if wala mo nag-andak o key informants inquiry, so you cannot really formulate this what we call research gap. Okay? So meaning, unsaon man nina mo ma'am para makakandak ni key informants inquiry. Okay, so for example, if ang imuhang respondents are farmers, so you can identify, you can conduct an informal interview to seven ka farmers. And then you just talk about things that are related to your field, like in the human resource, usual is job satisfaction, empowerment, motivation, etc. And if it is about some marketing, so it's more on buying decision, purchase intention, consumer behavior, etc. In the finance naman and accounting, you can actually explore about savings management, money management behavior, saving skills, budgeting skills, record keeping, and other more. So, sa kanang pito kabuok nga gikandakan nimo og KII guys, naa jud na sila something common nga ginatubag. Meaning, these are the common nga terms or variables nga nagawas sa pipila ka mga pipila ka mga respondents, prospect respondents nga imuhang i-interview. So if you identified that, then pwede na na siya nato nga himuon nga research gap. So, example problems, like, if we go with human resource, pwede tamo explore sa variable, pwede nga kani ang mga iingon sa ato ang mga prospect respondents, no? Job satisfaction, employee empowerment, employee work engagement, work-life balance, employee health and safety, occupational health and safety effectiveness, motivation, work or job stress, employee performance or HR practices, and a lot more. So, it could be nga ang ilang mga ginaingon sa mga empleyado, for example, sa Tadeco, is mauni siya nga mga problema ang nanggawas. So, if you identify that variable, then you already have your first variable, which is the dependent variable. So, how about sa marketing? Pwede nga ang ilahang iingon nga problema is related to buying behavior, marketing mix, service quality, customer relationship management, advertising, promotion, distribution, physical evidence, pricing, consumer behavior, purchase intention, e-commerce, social media marketing, and a lot more. And sa field naman sa finance management or sa accounting, it could be that the problems nga common nga mugawas sa prospect respondents are these following, no? Financial literacy, financial behavior, savings management, cost accounting and management, tax policy implementation or effectiveness, budgeting skills, business sustainability, risk management, financial management, tax awareness, accounting practices, internal control practices, record keeping practices, etc. Okay? So, kaning mga gi-mention ako diri, pwede ni siya ma-considered as the variables, no? The problem variables nga nagawas sa imuhang gikandak nga key informants inquiry. Okay, then also na ako'y nakalimtan, and to give you a specific pwede nga topics nga pwede na to explore sa tulo ka research agenda, I'll show you this ko ano file. Wait lang. Okay, yan. So, for example, sa mga themes nga pwede nato nga istudyahan, no, in the financial management, yan, kani. So, if it talks about environment, pwede ka mo discuss about variables relating to foreign investments, domestic investments, and financial analytics. Sa disaster naman, pwede ka mo discuss o financial stability of SME, credit and collection. Pwede po ka mo discuss o topic sa agriculture related about financial literacy of farmers, agriculture capital management, revenue or credit management, and business performance, effect of financial literacy, savings behavior, credit, or investment attitudes. Okay, those are just an example ha sa financial, pero actually, pwede pa ni siya ninyo madungagan. What you have to do is inyo lang siyang i-justify. Okay. Now, in the field naman of marketing, regarding sa environment, pwede tamo explore on marketing forecasting. Sa disaster naman, pwede po capital market. And sa agriculture related, pwede distribution of agricultural management, agriculture product management, yan. Agricultural produce, pricing strategy, customer service loyalty, buying behavior and customer satisfaction, impact of advertising, brand image, company image and brand loyalty. Okay? Then sa field naman of human resource and sa environment ta, pwede ta mag discuss about good governance and social responsibility, admin and office management. Sa dirian naman sa kaduha, like sa disaster, pwede nato i-explore variable about OD, labor law and legislation. Then sa dirian naman sa agricultural related, yung agricultural labor relation and negotiations and training and development of farmers. Okay, so actually naganiwala na apil diri katong about sa workplace health and safety, sa occupational health and safety, yun. And on the accounting, yun, actually daghan kayo sa accounting, oh. So pwede ma-discuss gani ang about audit reports of nature, ano, nature-based tourism, accounting information system, ethics in accounting, accounting management, yan, sa management accounting, yan din. Okay, so actually, daghan tag mga variables na pwede nato nga i-explore, guys. Pero daghan po tag dapat nga bantayanan whenever we are going to choose a variable. And I will discuss it to you kung unsa to siya. Okay, but first, let's go back to this topic, no? Balik ta diri, ah. So, yun. Ang first buhaton is magtandaktag informal interview para sa atong key informants inquiry to have that research gap. Again, balik ko na ako. Ang main purpose ng nanong nagkandaktag research is for us to address a certain issue or problem in a certain company, community, or organization. Okay, next. Note ha, variables are limited to 3 groups per class to avoid redundancy of titles. Labi na sa financial o accounting, nihit kaayo ang variable na to. No? Kay lisod pangitaon ang variable nga kanang measurable by 5-point Likert type or variable nga behavioral. Kasi mostly ang variable magudera is kanang numerical. No? And we are not going to study that numerical kasi dili na siya ma-assess in the quantitative na study. So, that is why mulimit ko o variable na gamiton. No? For example, if nagamit na sa human resource ang variable nga job satisfaction o katulo, tulo na kagrupo ang nagamit ana, then I will ban that variable and will no longer be used by the other groups. So, of course, first come, first serve ni. So, same as with the other program. Okay? Para ma-avoid ang balik-balik na title, no? Okay, ensure po nato na. Next, make sure that the variable that you wanted to study is behavioral in nature. Okay? Kanaganing objective ta when it comes to assessing it. Dili ta subjective. Okay? Dili ta, for example, kung ang variable is about sales growth, ma-answeran ba na siya by 5-point Likert type? The strongly agree, neutral, disagree, strongly disagree. Murag dili siya ma-answeran o 5-4-3-2-1. It can be answered by a numbers. No, kasi sales growth man siya. So, thus, we cannot really, although it's a variable, makonsider gihapon na to siya as variable, but in the side sa quantitative research, dili siya pwede na to ma-studyhan. Kasi it will, kailangan na to og numbers para makuha na siya. Example, profit. Okay, now, the question is, estudyante pa biya mo, no? Ihatag kaya na sa inyo ha sa mga company ang financial statements nila. So mo na siya no nga kana pa lang daan dili na jud, it's because it's very confidential. So and then yun na nga, it should be measurable by the 5-point Likert type. So if we say 5-point Likert type, yun yung 5-4-3-2-1, 5 is the highest. Okay, measurable ba na siya ana? For example, may tag, you wanted to study about the age gap of a certain community in the, what, sa mga farmer. So, kung ang imong studyhan is about sa age gap, dili man na nimo ma-measure o 5-point Likert type. Kasi, if we say age gap, it can be, you can acquire that by using the bracketing of the ages, no? So, dili siya in anak kasi yung variable, the measurable by 5-point Likert type is kanang behavioral siya ba? Dili jud siya inun nga kanang ma-measure siya just by the numbers. Okay? And it must not be hard to measure. mind you, na yung mga variable nga lisod i-measure, kailangan jud ka o ka na, kailangan ka o data nga kailangan pa og approval sa kataas-taasan before nimo siya ma-acquire. And remember, sa research ninyo karon, time really is of essence. So, if you will pick a variable, so make sure po na dili siya lisod i-measure, no? So, as much as possible, avoid nato ning a variable like this financial growth. So, pag measure ng financial growth, you have to compare your finances through a financial statement from previous to karon. Okay? So, ang pangutana, ihatag ba na sa imuha? No? Sabot na ning sales and profit. Even gani ang mga empleyado na ang company, dili mo gani maka-acquire ana. No? Financial performance, mahatag ba na sa to? Ma-measure ba na to 5-point like our type? Nga mo ingon ta nga, ang financial performance sa isa ka company is really doing well. So, dili siya inana. Tag return on investment. Return on investment has a computation. So, kung computation siya, nga namang gamito na to siya para ma-measure into 5-point Likert type. And even gani ako, empleyado ko, for example, ani diria sa UN, wala magani ko'y idea as to this matter, like in the financial statement, no? Or in the financial aspect diria sa UN. So, expect nga ka ng listed yun na siya ipang measure kasi confidential kaayo ang data. Nya, like, muingat ka ng turnover rate. Turnover rate is computed also. It also has a formula, no, sa side sa mga HR. So, kanang mga inaanang nga variable, as much as possible, as early as now, iwasan na ninyo. So, dapat, yung ano natin, yung variable natin, is ma-measure siya sa inyong respondents. Nga mismo sila naka-experience anang nga variable, then they have to measure it on how they agree about their ku ano about the statement that you made in your survey questionnaire. Okay, so now let's tackle about the variables of the study. So, since naka-identify naman tag problem sa organization, ang problem nga imong na-identify is ginatawag nga dependent variable. Now, this is the variable that you wanted to solve or address. Remember ha, it's the dependent variable. Okay? So, identify the variable that affect the problem. That's the next thing that you have to do. Giunsa nimo pag-identify ang dependent variable through KII. Okay? Then, katong mga requirements, prerequisites nga akong gi-mention ganina, dapat na suffice to nimo. So, next is dapat identify ta sa variable nga naka-apekto sa imong dependent variable. So, mo na siyang ginatawag nga independent variable. Okay? So, example, kung ang dependent variable nimo is job satisfaction because that is the problem, the variable that causes the increase and decrease of job satisfaction is employee empowerment. Thus, ang employee empowerment can now be considered as the independent variable. Okay? So, if ang problem nimo is about money management behavior, no? The variable that causes it nga magbaba or magtaas ang behavior on how they handle the money, siguro it's financial literacy, no? Kay kung mayong tag, kung financial literate pa lang ang isa ka tao, maayo na niya pag-manage ang iyang kwarta. Pero kung dili gani, kung illiterate gani financially ang isa ka tao, na ay possibility nga mag-mismatch niya ang iyahang kwarta. Okay, worst case is sige pa siya ka-scam. Same as the job satisfaction no nga. Kung empowered ang isa ka-empleyado, ang satisfaction niya is taas. Pero kung dili gani siya empowered to work in a certain company, satisfaction niya probably is baba. Okay, another. If the problem is purchase intention, no? Anong murag naakay intention to buy, to purchase that certain product, Now, the variable that causes it nga mag ano ba ko ani mo, dayon ba kong palit or dili? So, it could be the advertising or promotion. No, pagtarong ka ayo, pagwapo ang advertisement niya or pagpromote sa Prada, it could be that the purchase intention of the respondents is mag-increase. No, di ba? Pagwapo ang advertising niya o promotion no kay mas makuan ka, madani ka nga mupalit sa ilang produkto. Okay? So, yan. Yan ang correlation between IV and DV. Okay. Note ha, IV and DV can be interchanged. It is actually up to you on what problem or issue you wanted to address. Like for example, in here, si employee empowerment kay nahimo siya o kanang kung ano, independent variable. Pero pwede mong pod nga himuon siya o dependent variable. Unsa kay mga rason, mahimo siya problem, no, ang empowerment. Unsa kay rason nga nung dili siya empowered. Okay, so that's the time na naman na maghuna-huna ka og kanang things nga or variable nga nag-cause sa pag-increase or decrease niya. Okay, so dili jud na fix nga kani siya for IV jud ni siya, kani siya for DV jud ni siya, dili na siya fix. So it's really up to your kuan theory later on. Okay, mag-agad punta sa theory ana. So that's how you are going to identify your dependent and independent variable. Okay, let's go to variables, theories, and propositions. So identify the variable that affect the problem. No, if your group have decided the IV and DV, you are now ready to strengthen your hypothesis by searching the anchored theory and support proposition. Okay? Untahay, naka-identify na ka sa IV ni mo o DV ni mo. Now, ang ako mga yuuna po daan eh, nabakay anchored theory. Nabakay ka ng related literatures pod nga nag-ingon nga kana imuhang giingon nga si IV naka-apekto kang DV is true. Okay, so that's why need na to og anchor theory. Now, unsay difference sa theory and a proposition? A theoretical research is the systematic examination of a set of beliefs and assumptions. Now, it aims to learn more about a subject and help us understand it better. The information gathered in this way is not used for anything in particular because this kind of research aims to learn more. Okay, pag mo yung theoretical research, it is not just conducted on one experiment or on one non-experimental research. Okay, so usually, ang theoretical research, gi-conduct na siya multiple times para lang jud ma-prove ang isa ka theory multiple times. Okay? So, example of theory, kanang mga Maslow's Hierarchy of Needs, ERG theory, Lewin's Leadership Theory, Strategic Choice Theory, Critical Theory, Cultural Theory, and a lot more. Okay, usually, pag mag-identify ta og theoretical research that will support your assumption of IV and DV, yung ginakount lang nato nana is ang thought sa katunga theory. Kung ang thought niya mo fit sa imuhang assumption nga si IV and DV nakarelate, is related with each other, then pasok nana siya as a theory that you can use. Okay? Now, unsa dining proposition? No, it is a statement about the concept that may be judged as true or false if it refers to observable phenomena. When a proposition is formulated for empirical testing, it is called a hypothesis. No. So sa proposition, variables must be mentioned. So kani critical ta sa research proposition and kailangan mo follow ta sa 5 years recency in which dapat 2018 nga mga published journals pataas ang ato ang gamiton. So how are you going to identify this research proposition? Same gihapon. Dapat nag-istorya siya nga naay link si IV ug ang imuhang DV. Okay, so let's take this example adto daw ta sa Google Scholar. Yan. Let's go to Google Scholar. Okay. I actually have a published research, guys, which is also downloadable in Google Scholar kasi naka-indexed mangudiri ano. So, for example, kani, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, 6 na ang kuan, nawala na lang diri ang isa. Yan. Okay, so, itong study na ko, this is my dissertation work. Ito naman, this is my institutional research. And this is my research published together with my students, no? So, cited by 2 na yan. Ito cited by 1. And ito naman is my institutional, current institutional research. And this is the research study that I conducted in my program. Okay, let's check this. Kaning sa structural equation model na po. So, if you click this, you can actually download the PDF file of my research. Okay, medyo naghang pa siya. Okay, ayan. So, na-download na nato ang isa sa ako ang research, no? Entitled Structural Equation Model on Job Satisfaction Among Business Process Outsourcing Employees in Region 11. So, bali yung ginawa ko dito, guys, is ang respondents na ko is yung mga BPO employees sa entire Region 11. Okay. So, this is my paper. This is my advisor, Dr. Guhaw, no, which is also the official diri sa University of Mindanao. Okay, so asa man nato usually makita ang proposition? Usually it can be seen in the abstract, no? Kasi sa abstract, this is the summary of your paper or journal that you published, in which nga part na po diri ang pagbutang sa atong findings or sa research. Yun. Findings revealed that the level anana. Okay, so what if my study is about psychological empowerment and job satisfaction? So I have to find a proposition that said that psychological empowerment is related to job satisfaction, or psychological empowerment influences job satisfaction. So you have to read in the abstract kung naabay nag-state ana. Okay? And you also have to search journals from the different reputable na journal websites. Yan na nga, like Google Scholar, ProQuest, and others. So, let's check, no? That the level, yan in direkta sa correlation. In conclusion, tanaw ta dere sa iyang kuan. The most convenient concept. Okay, so it can be strengthened, but from meaning. Okay, in this part, wala siya na klaro o mention regarding sa psychological empowerment and sa job satisfaction. No, pero pwede tamutan-aw sa conclusion if we wanted to have a detailed na koan result. Check nato sa conclusion. Asa naman tong conclusion? Dara, conclusion and discussion. So let's go to the correlation na result, no? So sa correlation na result, dara, for the correlation, there is a significant positive relationship between psychological empowerment and job satisfaction. Yun. That statement will be your proposition. And you have to highlight it and you have to pass it to me and show it nga, ma'am, mauni akong proposition. But remember that I needed two propositions, no? So, from this journal, safe na ko sa isa. So, mag-search na po kong other journal nga nag-ingon nga si psychological empowerment kay related ni job satisfaction. So, that is how you're going to identify a proposition. So, usually, madali lang ang kuan pag-identify sa proposition. Yung theory ang medyo mahirap kasi you have to grasp for the thought niya ba. Kung naabay thought, naabay ka na sa theory, naabay nag-ingon nga theory nga naay the same thought aning ato ang assumption nga si psychological empowerment is related kang job satisfaction. Okay? So, going back in here, yun na yung about sa proposition. Okay. So, in searching for a theory and proposition, it must be from a renowned journal sites like Google Scholar, ResearchGate, Scopus Index Journal, and ProQuest, no? So, actually, sa library, naay kanang username and password for ProQuest and ResearchGate. So, you have to ask the lab or the ICT with regards sa username and password for this ProQuest para maka-access mo, makakuha mo sa full nga manuscript, no? Kay usually biya pag moadto ta sa kanang Google Scholar kay journal ra jud biya na ang iyahang iado. Journal ra jud na ang iyahang i-ma-download, dili jud ang full nga manuscript. And mas daghan maguntag makuha nga RRL o ma-learn sa kuan kung ang gamito nato is ang full manuscript. Okay, so let's proceed to the indicators or survey questionnaire. What is an indicator? It is something that points to, measures, or otherwise provides a summary overview of a specific variable. So, ang indicator, this is actually like when you are going to judge for a pageant, no? Natay mga criteria for judging. Pag mag-judge pa ta sa isang pageant, guys, ma-assess lang ba nato kung kinsa madaog based on her beauty, di ba, dili man. So daghan tag mga basehan. So it is just like this indicator. So for example, if my study is about psychological empowerment, so what is the indicator na ko nga makaingon ko nga empowered psychologically ang mga BPO? So psychological empowerment, so mo ni siya akong gigamit. I actually assess them based on meaning, confidence, competence, self-discrimination, and impact. Okay, so dili lang siya ingon nga psychological lang jud, no, nga kanang murag kana ra jud siya, isa ra jud variable ra jud, gi-categorize pa jud nato siya para ma-measure siya holistically ang ato ang variable. Then for job satisfaction naman, for job satisfaction, I use this indicator. Wait lang, wala. Job satisfaction, learning organization. Yan. For job satisfaction, I use several indicators like sense of work achievement, remuneration, satisfaction. Yes, superior satisfaction. Ang point ba, ma-measure ba nato ang satisfaction sa isa ka-empleyado based on remuneration satisfaction lang? Di ba dili? So, i-measure po nato ang kung naabay sense of work achievement na na-feel niya. Kung satisfied ba siya sa iyong superior, kung naabay work support, kung naabay colleague support, and naabay promotion opportunity. If they have provided all of that, it means that they are really satisfied in their job as a BPO. So, yan yung ginatawag na ito nga indicator. And careful ta kasi naamang ko yung mga study, no, na dili uso sa ilaha ang indicator. Diretso lang sila items in which nga it is much better that we have to consider indicators kasi para holistic ang mga items na ipa-assess nato sa ato ang mga respondents. So, now, what is the difference between a researcher-made and an adapted or modified questionnaire? Kasi mo relate man gud ni kay kung unsa ang indicator nga imong nakita, buhatan man na nimo questionnaire, no? Pero pag mubuhat ka questionnaire, naatay duha ka buok. Researcher meat. Okay, this is when the researchers formulated its own question based on the variables indicator. So, kung naka-identify ka og indicator, then per indicator, mag-provide kag tag lima ka-items matag indicator. Okay? So, lima ka-sentences matag indicator in which the respondents are going to evaluate it from the 5-point Likert type. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pero pag maingon gani tag adapted and modified questionnaire, published na daan na survey instrument sa isa ka journal, no? And already contains indicator and items of such variables. So this will be modified based on the researcher's respondents. And the researcher is not allowed to remove items from the journal. So meaning gi-adapt jud nato ang iyang gigamit. It's just that gi-modify nato siya based sa setting. So, for example, ako, if I have the questionnaire job satisfaction, pero BPO man to siya, and your kanang respondents or employees in kanang Tadeco or Sumifro, so you have to edit it, no? But then you are not allowed to remove an item or an indicator. So, that's the adapted and modified questionnaire. So, either of the two, kung wala tayo makita nga adapted na survey questionnaire, then we'll go with the researcher-made questionnaire. Okay. Now, how about sa title? Example, ang imuhang IV is mobile money usage and ang imuhang problem or the DV is spending behavior. Okay, among users in Tagum City. So, what would be your study looks like? So, mo ni siyang ginatawag nga correlational. Kaning tagtulo diri, these are the indicators of your study. Okay. So, ganyan yung itsura ng ano ni mo, no? Imuhang research outline. Then, if you go with one variable, this will be your title, no? Assessment on the money management. If ang imuhang gi-studyhan is money management, pero about working college students in Tagum City, you have to provide a plan or a program. Kaya meron tayong basis for training plan. Meaning, whatever the result of the money management na level, mag-provide ka ng training plan matrix para ma-improve or ma-enhance ang money management sa mga working college students. So, this will be your conceptual framework. Ganyan yung itsura ng conceptual framework natin. Okay, so yun ha, you have to decide if you go with one variable only or mag-correlational variable ta. Okay, so requirements na to for title proposal ay requiring everyone to pass and print the following. One, research theory, highlight the paragraph that you considered as having the thought of your study. Okay, number two, kailangan ako og duha ka journal for support theory or proposition. Remember ha, ang ato ang support theory or proposition, kailangan klaro nga na-mention ang duha ka variable. Ang research theory nato thought lang ang atong ginakount. Okay, number three, isa ka journal for IV and isa ka journal for DV indicator. So, dapat lahi-lahi nga journal ang source nato for DV indicator and IV indicator. And if mag-adapt ta o questionnaire, i-print jud ang original na survey questionnaire at the study published in a reputable journal. So this will serve as your support for the indicators. No need to pass item number 3 if in case nga mag-adapt ta o questionnaire. Kaya katong mga naa sa questionnaire na indicator, mao naman to ang imong support. Pero kung mag-researcher made ta, then we'll have to pass a journal kasi researcher made yung gagawin natin. Okay. Naiwit ang print the following. Note, all journals must be printed in its original form. Do not copy-paste. Okay, kailangan na ko ang original form and dapat ang proposition naka-highlight, ang theory naka-highlight, ang sa indicators naka-highlight. Dili kay giprint ra jud ninyo nya ako na inyong pabasahon. So dapat naka-highlight jud siya tanan, guys. Okay, so I think that's the end of my discussion, no? And I am hoping that on the next meeting na to is naana ni siya, and I can evaluate your paper for your title proposal. Okay, that's it, and have a good day.